गुड डे। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अगेन द सेम 18th लेसन जेनेटिक्स। इन दैट लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन अबाउट मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट डाईहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। सो इन डाईहाइब्रिड क्रॉस इट वाज क्रॉस वाज परफॉर्म्ड बाय मेंडल। He took two different characters what he took is one is he took seed shape and color as two different traits or character. Last cross monohybrid cross what we have seen is Mendel has taken only one character, that is height he has taken. In the height he has tall and dwarf plants, so he had only one character which is height in monohybrid grass. But now in dihybrid grass he has taken the seed shape and the color, so it is called as a dihybrid grass, the cross between two different parents which are differing in two different characters we used to say. So as usual the parents he took round yellow, round shaped yellow color seed and crossed it with that of wrinkled seed have green color. So this is the parent. The parents are always pure breeding. We know what is pure breeding. So if we perform more crosses then and that it used to give the same type of individual with it, that is called as pure breeding. A pure breeding is always homozygous, that is it will produce only one type of gametes, homozygous. So this is the parent. The parents are pure breeding and homozygous. And one parent is with round seed and yellow color seed and another one is having wrinkled shaped seed and green color. So earlier experiment Mendel know that this round yellow is dominant over the wrinkled green. So as usual this round is governed by an allele which we used to denote it with capital English letter, because we know that the round is dominant, yellow is dominant, so the corresponding capital letter Mendel used to have because of easy understanding. So he has given one dominant parent as capital R capital R and capital Y capital Y. Why we used to write two times means already we know that the factors are arising in pairs, so we used to write two times. So with that term the recessive parent, that is the corresponding smaller letter we used to have. So now we know that the parents are pure breeding homozygous, round yellow is dominant over the wrinkled green. For easy understanding we are using the corresponding English letters, capital and small letters we used to say. Since it is homozygous it will produce only one type of gamete, that is capital R and capital Y, and the recessive parent will produce also will produce only one type of gamete, that is capital R, sorry, small r and small y. So this is the gametes of parent. You used to remember that always the parents are pure breeding, so it used to give only one type of gamete, that is homozygous. Now these two are combined to form an individual, that is capital R small r capital Y small y, used to form an individual. So this we call it as F1 generation, first filial generation we used to say, and this F1 generation is called as a hybrid, and it is always the F1 is heterozygous.
Now let us continue. We know that now he has raised the F1 generation which is yellow and round yellow and it is heterozygous. first filial generation is showing dominant character, but genotypically it is having recessive characters also, but always in F1 the dominant characters will be shown as a phenotype. Externally it will be showing the dominant character. So now he has self-pollinated the F1 generation. So we will have four different types of gametes. Why? Because capital R and we have small r, and capital Y and we have small y. So this R can go with this capital Y and also with that of small y. So we have one gamete and we have another gamete. At the same time, the small r also can go with capital Y and also with that of small y. So we have four different types of gametes. So when we are self-pollinating, we know that one will come from a male parent, another will be coming from a female parent. So just we will multiply. So when we are multiplying these gametes, as far as easy understanding, we have got the phenotype and genotype like this. We have 16 individuals we have. So let us see, wherever we have at least a single R capital and single Y as a small letter, single Y as a capital letter, it will be more or less like F1. See, here one dominant character and one dominant character for color and shape is there. So whenever we have only one dominant allele for shape and for color, it will be round and yellow. So as it is, easily you can understand from this Punnett square. This is called as a Punnett square. Already we saw in monoimeric cross Punnett square. So now we have at one capital and one capital Y and one capital R. All these becomes round yellow. So we have out of 16, we have 9 round yellow. So that is 9/16. Will at least have one capital R and one capital Y, irrespective of the other. We don't bother about the second one. Whatever it is going to be a round yellow. And again, wherever we are having a both small letters for shape and one capital letter for color, we will be getting wrinkled yellow. So see this one, 1, 2, 3. So out of 16, 3 will be wrinkled yellow, or we say as your book, 3 yellow wrinkled, at least for one capital R irrespective of the other, and two small y will bring green round. So you see here, at least one capital R and both are small y, it will produce green color and round. So we have 3 green and round when all are recessive. We have the parent, that is recessive parent, one green wrinkled. So out of 16, one will be green and wrinkled. So the phenotypic ratio is of a dihybrid cross is 9:3:3:1 phenotypic ratio. That is, 9 will be round yellow, 1 will be wrinkled green, and we have two combinations we have. That is 3 round green and 3 wrinkled yellow we have. So this is a new combination we have. So this is what the dihybrid cross is. What we used to remember is, first while you are reading in the dihybrid cross, while you are reading, see about the definition. Then who performed the cross? Then what is a parent, what is the nature of the parents, then what is the nature of F1, then bring the F2 generation in Punnett square. And remember about the phenotypic ratio. And practice genotypic ratio also. How to write a phenotypic ratio is find out how many R, both capital R, capital Y is there. We can say only one we will be having like this, capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. So 1 is 2. How many are like this? Find out. We have 1, 2, and we have 1 is 2, 2 is 2. Like that, find the genotype and you find out how many are like that. In among the 16, you split the ratio for the genotype and you used to study. So this is what, while you are studying, these things you keep in mind and you have study. We will see in next video the loss of Mendel, that is on the basis of both monohybrid and dihybrid cross. He has given some ratio that we will be seeing in next video. Thank you.